But round one starts, and Montana does a great job of keeping her jab in her face, coming in a low stance, so keeping her legs bent, and really firing those one and twos up the middle.
Montana was definitely looking to take this fight to the ground. She shoots for a single leg, but Nico's too strong and has awesome takedown defense.
Montana's still, you know, trying to keep her there on the fence, and Nico finds space in the middle and fires a knee up the middle. It hits her right in the forehead and causes a big cut, and right away it started bleeding. And as a coach with two athletes in there that are on your team fighting each other, that was difficult for me to watch.
You can tell Montana was hurt after that knee to the head, and that was one nasty cut. But she hung in there in the clinch, and she was able to ride it out till the end of the round. Round two starts with both fighters trading shots. Then Nico sees the opening and gets a nice double leg takedown.
She got it. Montana, being the, you know, crafty jiu-jitsu player that she is, lands the tight guillotine. It looked deep. It looked like it was under the chin. And Nico sits there and takes her time and is able to pass the side control. And once she gets the side control, Montana has to give up on the choke.
Head, knock the head. I go to cage.
Nico starts landing really, really hard punches. A lot of hard punches. Hard rights, hard lefts, hard hammer fists. A couple good elbows. And Montana's fighting for her life down there.
Nico is connected with some hard shots.
Oh no.
They get back to their feet, and Nico lands some vicious knees, but Montana did not give up, and she was in there trying to win that fight all the way to the end. She is tough as nails, and what an awesome performance.
The judges have a unanimous decision for the winner, Nico.